Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God bless you on today and welcome. Welcome to Elinton Missionary Baptist Church, where we offer God our very best. And we're celebrating the goodness of the Lord each and every day of our lives, because this is the day that the Lord has made. And we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. Come on, somebody celebrate the goodness of the Lord. Hallelujah to the name of God. Glory. As you know, this is First Sunday, and on every first Sunday, it is our custom to commune together. And so we're going to ask that you would make sure that you get some bread and a cup that represents the body and the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because later in the service, we will commune together in the Lord. I can't even believe that it's already the first Sunday in September. We are in the third quarter of 2020. And listen, God has kept us, and he's keeping us even right now. So for all of you who are gathered, wherever you are, we just thank God for your presence, be it on our call to worship, being on the Facebook or YouTube. We just thank God for you. Make sure that you share, like, and subscribe, that we can be together and commenting and all of the rest as we worship God in spirit and in truth. At this time, I want you to receive the praise team as they bless us now in song.
Come on, those of you that are at home, let's put your hands together. Let me pray to our God.
Every prayer.
Deliverer,
Amen, amen. We thank God for our praise team and the gift of God in them to continuously bless us in song. It's prayer time. It's prayer time. It's time for the people of God to come together in unity on one accord to call out to our God who hears and answers our prayers. And we thank God. We thank God for the wonderful opportunity and privilege to pray. We take it not lightly. We appear to the words of Jesus that we ought to always pray, never cease from praying, because the place of worship is the house of prayer. Minister Robert Gambrell will lead us further in prayer. Receive him now.
Praise the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I will be reading from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 28 through 31. I think we all need to hear this in this day and time because we're putting our faith in other things other than God. Have you not known, have you not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, faints not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He gives power to the faint, and to them who have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for another day. Lord, we thank you for all that you've done for us. Lord, we thank you for the air to breathe. Lord, we thank you for the clothes on our back. Lord, we thank you for the food on the table this morning. Lord, we thank you for waking us up with your tender touch. Lord, we just thank you for all that you've done in our lives in the last week, the last months, Lord, during this pandemic. Lord, COVID-19 has no victory over us, Heavenly Father. Lord, we claim the victory in through you, Heavenly Father, that you continue to protect us from all hurt, harm, and dangers. Lord, we love you today, Lord. We give you all the praise, the glory, and the honor. Lord, I can't thank you enough. Lord, and it doesn't take a church. I don't have to be in a church steeple to give you the praise, Lord. I could be in a home, the grocery store, the car wash. It doesn't make it any difference, Lord. I love you today, Lord. I praise you wherever I am, Lord. I just thank you. Thank you. Thank you for this day. This is a day that you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Lord, I just thank you for my family, Lord. Thank you for the love. I thank you for Elyton Baptist Church, Lord. We ask that you bless our pastor and first lady right now in the name of Jesus. Bless the Miller family, Heavenly Father. Lord, we ask that you bless the ushers, the choir members, everybody. I miss everybody, Heavenly Father. Lord, we just ask that you touch them right now in the name of Jesus, all the ministers. Lord, we just ask that everybody is still ministering in this society right now, Heavenly Father. In this pandemic, Lord, this is the time that we have to let our light shine, Lord. And we ask that you, that everybody step up to the plate, Lord, and touch those who are in need. This is not over. It's not going to get easier. But Lord, through you, you're going to make it happen, Heavenly Father. Through you, we're going to be able to stand. We're going to be able to rise up as your people, Heavenly Father. We're going to let our beacon shine, Heavenly Father, where people know that we are saved, Heavenly Father. Know that we are a child of God, Heavenly Father, Lord. And we just going to give you the praise and continue to give you the praise, Lord. We thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for everything that you have done thus far, Heavenly Father. And we know blessings are still coming, Heavenly Father. Lord, we pray for those in the hospitals, Lord. We pray for those who are asked for prayer, Heavenly Father. Lord, we pray for those in the convalescent homes. Lord, we pray for those families that are going through, Lord, that are bereaved, Heavenly Father. Lord, we just ask that you touch them right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, we just claim a healing for those, Lord, who are praying and asking for a healing, Heavenly Father. Those in the hospitals, Lord, we ask that you continue to bless them, Lord. We just claim in the name of Jesus for a healing over their lives. Lord, we ask for the healing over the families that are bereaved. Lord, a lot of bereavement going on, Heavenly Father, Lord, and they need you right now. Lord, you are a father for the fathers. Lord, you are a mother for the motherless. Lord, and we ask that you continue to just be with those families right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask that you continue to bless those who are losing their jobs, Heavenly Father. We bless those, Lord, right now that don't know where to go, Heavenly Father. People have come up and asked, what must I do to be saved, Lord? And I say, you must accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. You must turn to God. You must read the Word. You must be stand strong in the Word. You must stand strong. You must be a child of God. Lord, we need you today, Lord. And it's just, there's just so much going on, Lord. And people are so worried about what they see on TV, what they hear about the White House, this president, that president, the coming president. Lord, we just ask right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just put everything in your hands. It's all in your hands, Heavenly Father. Lord, we just ask that you right now in the name of Jesus, just touch Washington, the White House. Lord, you know what's going on. You know what the future holds, Lord. And we just pray as Christians, Lord, that we just stand strong and trust in you. We're trusting in you right now, Lord. That's because we know this is where the strength comes from, Lord. These blessings we ask in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and thank God.
Amen. We thank God for the power of prayer. Hallelujah. Glory. We thank Minister Robert Gambrell for blessing us and leading us as we united together on one accord to pray to God. Amen. It is now time for communion. And so we ask that you would prepare your hearts, your souls, and your minds, that we can focus in on the Lord Jesus, the one who died for our sins and rose for our salvation. And on the very eve that he was betrayed, he told his disciples, he says, do this in remembrance of me. And my brothers and sisters, as we look back over this year and even beyond, you can remember what God has done for you. He's kept us, he's sustained us, and he's keeping us even right now. But nearly 2,000 years ago, Jesus kept us by the shedding of his blood. He died for you and for me. And so this is a very serious time for the believer. And we ask that you would gather now your bread and the cup that we might commune together. Yes, it was on the very eve that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread. After giving thanks, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples. And he says, as often as you do this, do in remembrance of me. For the bread represents the body of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Yes, the one, the incarnate Christ, who came in human flesh, that he might suffer, that he might hang on a cross for you and for me. And likewise, in the same manner, he took the cup, said, this is the new covenant, the shedding of my blood for many. He says, often as you drink it, do so in remembrance of me. What we must realize, my brothers and sisters, that when we commune together, not only are we communing with God, but we're communing with one another. And we show in our life, our deeds, even our talk, that we are connected to God and one another. And so communion should be preceded by self-examination, to examine ourselves and to ask God for forgiveness, that we might eat and drink in ways that are pleasing unto God. And so at this time, let us bow our heads and pray the communion prayer. Eternal and most loving God, the God of comfort, peace, love, and joy, you are all in all. And we bow in humble submission to the words of Jesus to remember what he's done for us. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your sacrificial love. If it had not been for you suffering, paying the price for our sins, dying on a cross, but being raised from the dead, we would be lost for eternity. But oh, hallelujah, we thank you. We thank you. We remember what you've done. We not only remember what you've done, we remember what you're doing even right now. And we praise you for what you're going to do in the future. So we pray that you would forgive us of our sins. Cleanse us of all unrighteousness. We confess our shortcomings. We confess, oh God, our sins before you. We confess that we have not always been the children of God that you've called us to be. Forgive us that we might eat and drink in ways that are pleasing and worthy before you. Thank you for the blood of Jesus that cleanses all of our sin. Thank you for divine forgiveness. And thank you, oh God, for allowing us to stand worthy in your presence and to commune with you and one another. So God, we pray that you would bless these elements, oh God, that represent your body and your blood. Bless it, oh God, in a manner that when we commune with each other, that the blessings of who you are in our lives would rise up and give us the passion and the love to live like Christ in every day of our lives. God, thank you. We give you praise, honor, and glory. This is our prayer. We pray it in the mighty, matchless, majestic name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. We do so in remembrance of you. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God said together, amen, amen, and amen. All right, all right. Now we ask that you would take the bread representing the body of the Lord Jesus Christ. Eat in remembrance of him. Now the cup, a new covenant of Jesus' blood shed for many. Drink in remembrance of him. For as often as we eat and drink, we do show forth the Lord's suffering and death until he comes again. And my brothers and sisters, he's coming. He's coming back for you, you, and you. He's coming back for a church without spot or blemish. I know it was the blood. Hallelujah. I know it was the blood for me. Amen, amen, and praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's giving time. It's giving time. Put those hands together and give God some praise, because listen, giving is worship. And when we worship God, we offer God our very best. And so I'm encouraging you, Elinton, and all of you who are viewing and listening, to be a blessing to this ministry, to do so in a way that we can be very impactful in ministry, that we can touch the lives of those who worship with us and those who worship in our community and live in our community and even abroad. And so we need you to give in a manner that bespeaks your love for God. For God is in truly been faithful. And listen, we want to be faithful givers, faithful and cheerful givers, given in a manner that bespeaks who we are and what we believe and trust in, and that's worshiping God in all that we do. Listen, you can give through the mobile app Gilify, and we encourage our members to do so. We're doing things anew in a new excellent way. And so I want to challenge you not to be afraid of technology, but to use it to be a blessing to the kingdom of God. And then, my brothers and sisters, you can also mail your offerings to Elinton Missionary Baptist Church, P.O. Box 13219, Detroit, Michigan, 48213. That's Elinton Missionary Baptist Church, P.O. Box 13219, Detroit, Michigan, 48213. And listen, God loves a faithful giver. Let's bow our heads. Eternal God, thank you for this, another opportunity to worship you in our giving. Because God, all that we have comes from you. And we thank you for the many gifts, the many blessings that you bestowed in our lives. And so God, we ask that you would receive these gifts as our offering unto you. We ask that you bless it, bless the givers. Oh God, that you might be glorified. In Jesus' name, we thank you. Amen and amen. Amen. Amen, amen. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. I want to thank you for your faithful and obedient giving. Giving is worship. Giving is worship. And when we worship, we ought to offer God our very best. And I trust that you're doing just that, my brothers and sisters. Amen. I want you to receive the praise team once again as they bless us in song.
Ah.
Amen. To the majestic, marvelous, magnificent, munificent Lord who is, who was, and who is to come, the Almighty, we give him praise, honor, and glory on this first Sunday because he's worthy of praise, not just on Sunday, but every day of our lives. Come on, celebrate the goodness of the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Give him the fruit of your lips. Come on and worship him. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. We thank God for God's presence. We thank God for each and every one of you who are viewing and listening on our online service. Again, we want you to subscribe. We want you to share. We want you to start a watch party. We want to connect with others that the gospel of Jesus Christ, that the message of our Lord is going out throughout this world. So we need you to do that. Make sure that you're commenting in the comment section throughout this service. We want to be able to connect. We want to lift up our viewing. We want to do that to lift up the name of Jesus and glorify him. And so God, we just thank God for all of you on today, and to our praise team. We thank God for them again, our musicians. And we thank God for our audiovisual team who have blessed us, and each and every one for all that you do. Amen, amen. I want to call your attention to the Old Testament, the book of 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles chapter 20 will serve as my text. However, for your hearing, I'm going to read verses 14 and 15. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 14 and 15, which says these words. Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehaziel, son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jehiel, and Mattaniah, a Levite and descendant of Asaph, as he stood in the assembly. He said, "Listen, King Jehoshaphat, and all who are living in Judah and Jerusalem, this is what the Lord says to you. Do not be afraid or discouraged because of this vast army, for the battle is not yours, but God's." The battle is not yours, but God's. And from this, I want to talk from the subject, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Come on, tell somebody near you. Matter of fact, tell yourself that the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. There are some battles in life that are too big, too bad, too rough, too tough, and too much for you to attempt to fight, my brothers and my sisters. Yeah, it doesn't matter how big, how bad, how rough, how tough, and how much you can handle. There are just battles in life that are not yours to fight. They are the Lord's. Yes, yes, we are more than conquerors. I know that we're strong and mighty in the Lord. Yeah, we know that we've been appointed and anointed by God, and we can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens us. Nevertheless, I need somebody to hear me. There are some battles, some enemies, issues, some concerns and crises that will arise in our lives that will set off an inner a warning, an alarm from God that will tell us that you're outnumbered, outgunned, outwitted, underfinanced, underpowered, and about to lose control. Oh yeah, God will warn you that the battle's not yours. But although God sends an alarm, there's a problem with many of our response. Yeah, I'm referring to us who confess faith in the Lord Jesus. Yeah, God will set off an alarm to warn us not to go in battle or to get us to get out of the battle. Is anybody hearing what I'm saying? Or plainly alarm and alert us that the battle is not yours. Said the Lord, it's mine, it's mine. But there we go. There we go. More than a conqueror, strong and mighty. I'm talking about a super Christian. Yeah. I know we appointed and anointed by God, and we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. There we go. Headed straight out for the battlefield. Got our whole armor of God on, singing on the battlefield. I'm on the battlefield for the Lord. So we think. Yeah, because in essence, my brothers and sisters, when God has warned us to stay off the battlefield, when God has set off an alarm and let us know that the battle is not yours, it's the Lord. And in essence, when we're fighting against God, when we don't listen to the words and heed to the words of God, we're fighting against the Lord's word, the Lord's will, and the Lord's way. Am I talking to anybody today? You see, when we refuse to let go and let God fight God's battle, we're fighting against God. Yeah, when we insist on helping the Lord fight the Lord's battle, we're fighting against the word, the will, and the way of God. When we attempt to fight battles that are not intended for us to fight, oh yeah, we're fighting against God in ourselves. Oh yeah. We're trying to fight spiritual warfare with no spiritual strategies. Yeah, we're engaging in warfare that we have no control over and that we cannot win, because we're fighting against God's word, against God's will, against God's way, and we don't even realize it. Yeah, I'm talking to you, super Christian. I'm talking to you, Bible-carrying, verse-calling Christian. I'm calling to you who's strong in faith and can do all things in Christ Jesus. When God calls and alerts us that the battle is not ours and it's the Lord's, we ought to heed to his word, his way, and his will. See, that's the problem. We who confess faith in the Lord, we sometimes demonstrate a lack of faith in God's word, and particularly in times of a struggle, in times that we're dealing with even right now. Our confession of faith does not align with our behavior. We say one thing by faith, but our behaviors are not those of faith. We won't trust in the Lord. Am I talking to somebody? I'm talking about with all our heart. We won't do that. We won't acknowledge the Lord in all our ways. You don't have to say amen. And we're not following God's direction because we're leaning to our own understanding. Yeah. That's the dilemma. That's the dilemma, my brothers and sisters. In times of crises, we sometimes lack the faith to let go and let God fight God's battles. Yeah, the battle's not yours. Yeah, some battles are not yours. They're the Lord's. They're the Lord's. They're the Lord's. And you know, in this time of pandemic and upheaval in our world and all that's going on, you know, we can't fight all of that. You can't handle all of that. It doesn't matter how big, how bad, how rough and tough and how much you can handle. Some things are left up to the Lord, but there are some things that we can do. There are some things that we can do. But I hear some of you even saying, now, Pastor, preacher, how do I differentiate my battles from the Lord's battles? Anybody hear me? Yeah, how do I differentiate my battles from the Lord's battles so that I can be in the will of God? Let me show you how to differentiate. If all you can think of is the crises of your current concerns and circumstances and situation, day in and day out, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. If you lost your appetite and you find it difficult to fall asleep at night because your thoughts are racing and you can't quiet your mind long enough to relax and find some rest and sleep, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Yeah, if your circumstances have isolated you from those who are closest to you, listen, my brothers and sisters, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. If your issues have caused you to feel stressed out, overwhelmed with anxiety and depression, the battle's not yours. No, no, it isn't. The battle is the Lord's. If the battle that you're fighting has elevated your blood pressure and deteriorated your overall health, somebody help me preach. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. It's the Lord's. Yeah, if your battle strategies have convinced you to substitute your peace with pills, yeah, your comfort and contentment with cocaine, heroin, or any other illicit drug or alcohol or any immoral vices, the battle it's not yours. It's the Lord's. If you're at a place in life, and I know I'm talking to somebody. And you're powerless and you don't know what to do. Yeah, the battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. And see, that's why I wanted to talk about this, because we're experiencing a battle right now in our world. Somebody ought to say amen. Yeah. Comment in the comment section that, I'm experiencing a battle right now. Yeah, because we're going to face some battles, even if you're not facing one now. But in the days ahead, the days that approach, you're going to have to face some battles in life. Therefore, it's imperative, my brothers and sisters, that we be able to fully trust God. Trust God to fight the battles that are too big, too bad, too tough, too rough, and too much for you to handle. Too much for you to fight. Yeah, we must believe, hallelujah, that God can and God will. He'll fight those battles. But in order for us to know what the battle is, that it's not ours, or if it is ours, or if it's the Lord's, we need to understand that it requires an unwavering faith in God and in God's word. Let me say that again. In order for us to know that the battle is not ours and that the battle is the Lord's and that God will fight that battle, it requires an unwavering faith. Anybody got an unwavering faith? No doubt, no fear in God's word and in God. So I wanted us to look at this 2 Chronicles chapter 20, because there are some specific acts of faith by King Jehoshaphat and all of the people of Judah that demonstrate the kind of faith in God and in God's word that we need in times of crises, in times like these. So the question becomes, what are those acts of faith that will show us that the battle is not ours, that they're the Lord's? That we can grasp on by faith, by trusting in the Lord. Let's look at the text. You see, King Jehoshaphat, he's the fourth king of the southern kingdom of Judah. He was a godly king who removed idolatry from Jerusalem and Judah. He made sure that the people of God were educated in the word of God and the law of God. He was responsible for the reorganization in the administration of justice, and he had a well-trained military. So in obedience and trust in the Lord, King Jehoshaphat was able to strengthen the kingdom of Judah. But all of a sudden, they got word in their prosperity, in their peace. They got word that the Moabites had formed a great power of confederation with the Ammonites and the Midianites, and surrounded the nation and came out against King Jehoshaphat. Don't you know, my brothers and sisters, that things can be going well and you can be obedient to the will of God, faith and trusting in God, and all hell breaks loose in your life? Is there anybody out there hearing what the Spirit of the Lord is saying? You know what I'm talking about. Everything was going well in 2020. We were praising the Lord. And all of a sudden in March, it seemed like the whole bottom had dropped out of all of our lives. We're facing a battle. It's not ours. No, it's the Lord's. We're facing some trying times. And the battle's not yours. It's the Lord's. Word came to Jehoshaphat, and here's what the king, he was alarmed, the text says. But hallelujah, he turned his fear into faith. What are those acts of faith needed for us to know that the battle is not ours and that it's the Lord's? Well, the first thing that we can do, my brothers and sisters, what Jehoshaphat did was he sought the Lord. Yeah, he was seeking the Lord. That's what the text says. Yeah, he was afraid, but he turned his fear. He was alarmed, but he turned his fear, hallelujah, into faith. He himself and all of Judah. You know, as a people of God, we got to come together. All of us got to come together and seek the Lord. He tells them to fast and to pray. He calls a national, you know, fast and pray. You know, and listen, I need to say this, that the people of God, we need to come together. Yes, we do. And pray. Yeah, Elinton, we got a call to pray line that on every Wednesday at 6 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. But listen, there's a handful of people of God of Elinton. All of us, as they were here, if we're going to seek the Lord, we need to seek the Lord together. It said all of Judah, all of his children, all of the wives. You know, and I'm just need to say, somebody need to go wake up them kids right now. Yeah. So, that's right. You need to wake up your husband, your spouse, your boo. You need to wake them up right now so that we can seek the Lord together. Am I talking to anybody? He calls a fast and a prayer, and listen, they came together and did so. And if you're gonna let the Lord fight your battle, you need to seek the Lord, get a word from the Lord. Notice Jehoshaphat, the king didn't call for the military. No, he didn't. No, the king didn't call for the government. He didn't call for the administration of justice. He didn't call on the army. He didn't call on anybody. He didn't call on any Confederate nations that surrounded them for help. He didn't call on any political affiliations that could give him help. No, he called the Lord. They called on the Lord. And listen, during these times of crisis and difficulty, the people of God need to seek the Lord. We need to call on the Lord. Is anybody hearing what I'm saying? Can I get two people to say amen? Yeah, somebody comment in the comment section that the Lord is who we ought to call. It's the Lord that they were seeking. Who are you seeking in this time of crises in your life? You need to know, we need to know, is this our battle to fight? And when we're not seeking the Lord, we're seeking advice from other people, my brothers and sisters. Oh, yes, we are. Yes, we are. Yeah. A lot of us are seeking advice or seeking advice from some news station. Yeah. Some of us are on some cable TV network, you know, 10 hours a day watching what the news say. Yeah. Some are looking to see exactly what the CDC is saying. But in times of crisis, we need to hear a word from the Lord. Come together. They came together. They fasted and prayed. And listen, He wasn't praying or seeking no advice from nobody but the Lord. Notice in his prayer, verses 6 through 12, you need to read it for yourself. Yeah, the king got that. He prayed and listen, and it was just one prayer, but the people were praying together. Anybody hear what I'm saying? We can come together with one prayer on one accord, praying to one God. Cool, hear our prayer. He said, look, I'm talking to the eternal God. He talked to the God of eternity, the Lord of our ancestors, the Lord of our silent tears and our weary year. He's calling on the God that has been there for him as a people through thick and thin, through the ups and the down. He called on the majestic God, the God of heaven. He called on the God who is sovereign, the God who rules over kingdoms and nations and the world. He called on the omnipotent God, the God who has all power in his hand. Does anybody know who I'm talking about? He called on God. He was seeking God, God's providence, God's benevolence, God's love. He was calling on the omnipresent God, the omniscient God, the God who knows everything. God, the protector, God. God of justice, God who is Savior and our helper. I want you to hear his prayer. He ends his prayer at verse 12. He says, for we are powerless against this great vast army that is coming against us. We don't know what to do, but our eyes are on you. God, we're powerless. We don't know what to do, but our eyes are on you. We're seeking you, God. Anybody seeking the Lord's guidance? Anybody seeking the Lord's love? Anybody seeking the Lord's care? Is anybody here? Or am I just talking to myself? Come on, put in the comments section that you're seeking the Lord. Seeking the Lord, I need some direction in this time. My employer can't give me that direction. I need some direction in times of crises. Yeah, my self-help book won't help me right now. My money in the bank won't help me right now. Somebody ought to shout, God, I'm seeking you. Anybody seeking the Lord with all your heart, with all your mind? He said, we're powerless. You see, the king had sense enough to know that there's some things that we just are powerless against. He said, we can't fight this army. He said, we don't even know what to do. But our eyes are on you, God. Hallelujah. Our eyes, yeah, we got to seek the Lord, seek the Lord. But meanwhile, what happened is, then the Lord sends a word. And that's one thing about prayer. God will answer your prayers. And as they were there, the children of Israel, or the children of Judah, all of them was there. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jehaziel. Now, and he says, listen. Because see, God has got a word for you. When God's got a word, God said, listen, behold, listen to what thus saith the Lord. And I want you to hear what the Lord tells him. He said, don't you fear, don't you be discouraged at this great vast army. Or whatever it is that you're going through, don't you be afraid, don't you be discouraged. For the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Hallelujah. Has somebody need to hear me? Yeah, there's some battles in your life. You trying to fight those battles? You trying to deal with those? You need to let the Lord fight those battles. Am I preaching to anybody today? Are you hearing what thus saith the Lord? But he goes on and says that, he says, tomorrow, I want you to go down against them. But he reminds them that this battle is not yours to fight, but I want you to go down. And he says, I want you to take position. I want you to stand still. I want you to see the victory of the Lord on your behalf. But the battle's not yours. You see, when the battle is not yours, don't mean that we give up, run, and hide, isolate ourselves. No, my brothers and sisters, it's that we have to face tomorrow. He said, tomorrow, we have to be able, God wants us to face tomorrow. We need to listen to what thus saith the Lord. He said, don't you be afraid. You got to face your circumstance. Don't you be discouraged. Don't you let no pandemic discourage you. Don't you be afraid of what the president of the United States and the government. Don't you allow them to steal your joy and put fear in your heart. Fear not. These are the words of God. We have to listen. Anybody listening to what the Spirit of the Lord is saying in this place today? He said, look, I want you to go down. And they were listening. He said, the battle's not yours. I want you to take positions, you know. And then he gives them some more exhortation. Again, the Lord says to him, don't fear, don't be dismayed. And I always wonder why, you know, God would tell him a second time, because God knows us. He knows our hearts. He knows our way. He knows that we lean to our own understanding, because many times in the word of God, it says, do not be dismayed. Do not fear. And we do exactly what God tells us not to do. Don't you worry about nothing. And yet we worry. And you know, we start, you know, negotiating with God and with ourselves. Well, you know, Lord, we human. Yes, you are. Yes, we are. Lord, I don't know why we got to take position if we ain't got to fight the battle. Lord, if the battle is yours, why we need to pray? We just, by faith, know you're going to take care of it. But notice they didn't do any of that. They listened. Somebody need to hear what I'm saying. Once you've prayed, you ought to listen for God to speak to your heart, speak to your soul and your mind. Cut that TV off. Cut that phone off. Get in your prayer closet and hear a word from the Lord. Listen to what thus say of the Lord. Am I talking to anybody? Yeah, push that plate back from the table. Get up out that refrigerator and fast. Seek God's face. So you can hear from the Lord. He said, don't look, don't you be afraid. Don't be discouraged. God is speaking to somebody right now. I pray that we're listening to what thus saith the Lord. God is whispering into somebody's ear right now that you need to face tomorrow. Stop hiding from tomorrow, because every day is a day that the Lord has made. I want you to face tomorrow with rejoicing in your heart. Don't allow fear to steal your joy, my brother, my sister. He said, I want you to take some position. You see, there's some things that we got to do, even though we don't have to fight the battle. You got to get up, wash your face off, and face. You got to face tomorrow. You got to face your enemies. You got to face your problems. You got to face them, but knowing that God is going to fight. They already got a word. God said, I'm going to fight the battle. You don't have to fight. But thank God for King Jehoshaphat and his leadership and the people of God. Because not only did they listen, they obeyed. They didn't question God. They didn't lean to their own understanding. They just obeyed what thus saith the Lord. Pick up your Bible and listen to what God is saying. God is speaking. Are we listening? And then this is what I love about the text. After they heard a word from the Lord, text said that they fell down. King Jehoshaphat, he fell down on his knees. He bowed down and he worshiped. Somebody missed that. Whenever you get a word from the Lord, hallelujah, every time that God speaks to your heart and your mind, you ought to fall down on your knees and worship him. You ought to give him praise, honor, and glory. Said they began to sing praises. Yeah. If the God of the universe, the God who's in control, if the God who's going to fight your battle tells you he's going to fight your battle, somebody ought to shout hallelujah, Lord, and give him some worship. Bow down and worship him. You on holy ground. When God invites you into his presence, when God speaks to you, when he speaks to me, we ought to worship him. They worship him. It says that the king bowed down his face, and all of the inhabitants of Jerusalem, they fell down before the Lord, worshiped the Levites and the Korahites. They all got up and stood up. They began to praise the Lord. They began to sing songs loudly before the Lord, praising God, that God hears and answers our prayers and that he'll fight your battles. I think we ought to just take a few moments out right now. To give God some praise. I think all of us, we need to give him some praise. I think all of us, if God has heard and answered your prayer, if God is speaking to you right now, if God is saying, I'll fight your battle, stand still and know that you will see victory in the name of the Lord, you ought to just jump up on your feet, get up off that couch. You ought to praise the Lord, worship him, bow down. You're on holy ground. Yeah, and see, holy ground ain't in the sanctuary. Holy ground is wherever the Lord shows up. And if he shows up in your prayer closet, you ought to worship him. If he shows up in your mind and your heart, you ought to shout hallelujah. They praise the Lord. They worship him even in the midst of a battle. When they were outnumbered, outgunned, and overwitted, and all of the rest, they still were able to worship the Lord. See, my brothers and sisters, when we don't worship the Lord in difficult times, we're saying to God, we don't trust you. We're saying that we got a lack of faith in you. But thank God for the people of Judah, their children also, their wives, the whole family, the whole kingdom came together. And they acted in obedience. It said the next day they rose up, and they rose up early in the morning, and they went out into the wilderness and did exactly what God told them to do. And Lord Jesus, we need to do the same. We need to stop laying down in our beds and saying, woe unto me. I know you lost a loved one. I know you know some folk that are sick. I know you may have lost your job, but still you can rise up in the power and the might of his word and be obedient to his word. He said, they got up. And then the king, and he encouraged them. He said, listen, he says, I want you to believe in the Lord your God, and he'll establish you. Believe in God. Believe in his word. The Proverbs, it says that we got to trust in the Lord with all of our heart. Lean not to our own meager, finite understanding, but in all our ways, acknowledge him. And he will. He'll direct your path. They got up. They got up in obedience. And when they got up, they started praising again. They were praising when they first got a word. They just started praising the Lord. Now they headed to a battle with a vast army that they can't even deal with. They outgunned and all of the rest. But yet they praising the Lord. It said they just broke out with a song. Somebody need to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. And they praised him in holy splendor. Yeah, they got up. They got up before the army. Yeah, and they were saying, give thanks unto the Lord for his steadfast love. Love endures through all generations. We need to get up out of our sorrow, get up out of our fear, and praise the Lord. And look, my brothers and sisters, they were praising the Lord before the battle was won. We think we can't praise God until the battle, until the victory is won. But the Lord is saying to us, get up and sing a song. Sing a song unto the Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. Our God is able. Smoky North folks said, blessed assurance. Hello, fear. I knew I would see you, and it was a hard time letting you go. Yeah, these tears, take a good look, because soon they'll fall no more. God is healing my hurt places. Yeah, the seat that was yours is now taken. No longer am I afraid. I'm better this way. And one thing you need to know before I leave, farewell, fear, goodbye. Farewell, fear, goodbye. Get you a song in your heart, my brothers and sisters. Oh, how 'tis so sweet it is to trust in Jesus. 'Tis so sweet to trust in the Lord. 'Tis so sweet to take him at his word. You better get you a song. Yeah, see, they were singing. See, when you have faith and trust in the Lord, you can sing a song in pandemics. You can sing a song in the midst of loss and financial reversals. You can sing a song and praise to the Lord. Even before the battle. Yeah, even before the battle. Somebody ought to be praising him right now. Yeah, you want a victory. God's going to fight your battle. You ought to be thanking him right now for fighting your battle. You ought to thank him right now that he's standing there for you. Standing. He tells you to stand still so I can fight your battle. Get a song. They praise the Lord. Now watch this in the text. Verse 22 says that as they were singing praises unto the Lord, and you know, Paul and Silas know about praising the Lord in difficult times. Yeah. Mary and she knows that when difficult times and the Lord has delivered, you need to sing a song. Yeah, they were singing and praising the Lord. And then all of a sudden it said that the Lord put an ambush out on their enemies. Don't you worry about your enemies. You just worship and praise the Lord. Don't you worry about your naysayers and haters. You just praise the Lord and God will fight your battle. Yeah, they ambushed. And I want you to see this. You need to go back and read this in the text, because in the text it said that the Ammonites and the Moabites, they attacked their other Confederate friends and armies on the Mount of Shira. Yeah, they attacked one another. Yeah, the enemy, instead of attacking, Jerusalem and Judea, they attacked one another. Don't you know God will take care of your enemies? And your enemies will destroy themselves. You ain't got to worry about destroying your enemy. You don't have to worry about revenge. You just let the Lord fight his battles. Hey, you stand up all night and figure out how you gonna get somebody back. Yeah, you worried about what they're doing in the White House. You just stand still and see the victory and see the power of the Lord in your life. Sing a song, give him praise. You worried about what the doctor said. Hallelujah. Don't you know that Jesus is the doctor? Yeah, don't you know he can heal your body in the midst of your praise? Don't you stop taking your medicine. Don't you stop doing what the doctors say. But what you don't want to ever stop doing is praising the Lord. Because in your praise, in your song, in your heart, oh, he'll fight your battles. Yeah, he's taking care of the enemies, and they ain't even got to the area. They got there and saw that their enemy was already destroyed. That's right, my brothers and sisters. You'll wake up one morning, and all the enemies that come against you will be destroyed, and you'll have glory. And it said that they had so much plunder, they just went by and took what they wanted, from the enemy. They just, they didn't have to fight. All they had to do is stand still. Don't you know God will bless you in abundance when we obey his word, when we trust in him and stop leaning to our own understanding? Can't you see them? It said it took them like 4 days to get all their blessings. Don't you know you haven't been blessed in some months? Maybe you haven't seen like God has blessed you with that blessing that you've been asking for. You just hold on. You just keep on praising him. You just keep on doing what the Lord said. Keep on listening to the Lord. Don't you be afraid. Trust in him. Obey him. Worship him. And hallelujah, he'll open up the windows of heaven and pull you out some blessing that you don't have room enough to receive. Anybody want the blessings of the Lord? Somebody ought to shall bless me, Lord. Put that in the comment section. Lord, I'm going to listen because I realize the battle's not mine. Bless me, Lord. I'm going to worship him. I'm going to worship him. And then my brothers and sisters, I'm finished. You know, after they got there and they saw that the Lord did what the Lord said, that he would fight their battles, they realized that was time for another praise. Yeah, they praised him before the victory. Yeah, they praised him after the victory. Somebody ought to stand on your feet. Somebody ought to praise the Lord. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. They praise the Lord. They thank God even before the battle, but after the battle, that they did not have to fight. Praise the Lord. And listen, I think it's a good time for some of us right now. Yeah, right where you are. I think it's a wonderful time. I know you still going through right now. That's all right. You ought to get up on your feet. You ought to open your mouth. You ought to shout hallelujah. You ought to praise the Lord. Will you praise the Lord with me? They praise the Lord all the way back to Jerusalem, to the temple. And I need to tell somebody, yeah, we may not be at the temple. We may not be in the sanctuary, but we ought to praise them, because when they got back to the sanctuary, they broke out in another praise. You ought to get ready to get back in the sanctuary. You don't have to wait till you get to the sanctuary, but when you get to the sanctuary, we ought to praise the Lord. Praise him. Because the odds were stacked against us. We were all destined for hell and the grave, never to rise again. But one Friday, somebody ought to hear what I'm saying. The Lord said, don't you be discouraged. Don't be afraid. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. And the Lord died one Friday, but he rose early Sunday morning with all power in his hand. He'll fight your battles. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Oh, yeah, he's fighting somebody's battle right now. Oh, hallelujah. You ought to hear his voice. Stand still and know that I'm the Lord. Stand still. The battle is not yours. It's mine. Woo!
Fight on. I got a feeling. I got a feeling that everything's gonna be all right. I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. My big brother, your big brother, our Lord and Savior, he's fighting the battles right now. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Shout yes! True yes! Shout yes! Praise him! Praise him! Praise him! Yes! Yes! Praise him! My battles. I'm gonna praise him. I'm gonna praise him. I'm gonna praise him with all my heart, all my soul, all my mind. Bow down and worship him. Praise him to the rising of the sun, to the going down of the same. Praise the Lord. Woo! Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't God fight your battles? Won't he do it? I'm gonna praise him. I'm gonna praise him before the victory comes. I'm gonna praise him. Praise him. Yes! Woo! My big brother, he is all powerful, all knowing, all seeing. Yes, he is. Church, come on, Eloton, come on, people of God, praise him, praise him, praise him. He'll fight your battles. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord. The battle's not mine. It's the Lord. It's the Lord. It's the King of Kings. It's the Lord of Lords. It's the great I am. It's his battle. And he'll fight for you. Lift him up, 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 lift him up. Somebody lift the Lord right now. Glorify his name. feeling that everything's gonna be all right. I got a feeling that everything is gonna be all right because the Lord is fighting my battles. I got a feeling that everything is gonna be all right. I got a feeling deep in my heart, deep in my soul. I got a feeling that everything's gonna be all right. Somebody ought to praise him. Praise him right now. Don't wait till the victory comes. Praise him in the midst of the battle. Stand still and see the salvation. See the victory of the Lord. Hey! Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory. Glory to the Lamb of God. He'll fight your battles. Because there are some battles, my brothers and sisters, that are too big, too bad, too rough, too tough, and too much for you to handle. But if you cast all your cares on him, call out, seek to the Lord. He'll answer your prayers. Listen to the voice of God. He'll give you direction. And when you hear from him, worship him, praise him, even before the battle. And as you're praising him, he'll open your eyes of faith to allow you to see that the enemy has been conquered. And you'll wake up the next morning being blessed in abundance that you can head back, hallelujah, to the sanctuary, to the temple, to give God praise forever, forevermore. I want to extend an invitation to someone who may not know Christ as their Savior. He wants to fight your battles. He died one Friday, but he rose Sunday morning that you might have life and that more abundantly. Yes, Jesus, he took on the battle of sin and death and the grave. And he won that we might have life and that more abundantly. So all you have to do is text your name to join at elintonmbc.org. And our team will call you and speak and pray with you. You ought to come. You ought to come to Christ just as you are. Not with fear. Turn it in for faith in Jesus. Not being discouraged, but to hear a word from the Lord that he has, that he will fight your battles. God bless you, because the battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. Amen. Amen. And amen. God bless you. I want you to now I'll receive our ministry highlights at this time.
Praise the Lord, saints. Psalms 34 and 8 tells us, "Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in him." We pray that all is well with you, and we're trusting that God continuously meets all of your needs during this time. Attention all Detroit Public Schools Community District students, parents, and guardians. Any K-12 DPSCD student enrolled in the district during the spring membership count that occurred February 2020 is eligible to receive a wireless tablet device, LTE data for 6 months, and technical support, including 2020 graduates that finished in June. If your device is not claimed by fall 2020, the district will distribute devices to new students pending availability. Make plans to pick up your device this week. Low-cost community resources provided by our COVID-19 committee is located on the Illiton MBC SM Facebook page. We are committed to your spiritual growth and connecting with you using alternative methods for worship services, Bible studies, and meetings. To receive updates by email, send your request to email address normaraws@yahoo.com. That's NORMARAWLS@YAHOO.COM or by phone at 313-921-4073, extension 10. Sunday school is each Sunday at 9 a.m. Contact Norma Ross by email or phone for the Zoom app login and password. A call to worship service begins each Sunday at 10:30 a.m. A call to pray is every Wednesday at 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. A call to Bible study begins each Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. Worship services, Bible studies, and prayer will be conducted on our conference call line. The direct number to call in is 515-603-5693. Worship services will also stream live on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Please like, share, and follow us on all social media platforms at IllertonNBCSM. To partner and support us in ministry, please share your tithes, offerings, and gifts in two ways. By mail, P.O. Box 13219, Detroit, Michigan 48213. Do not send mail to the physical church address, 8935 St. Cyril. You can also give using the secure mobile app Givelify. Download Givelify at your Google or App Store. Please remember our sick and shut-in, bereaving families, and our entire congregation with calls, texts, cards, and prayers. Thank you for tuning in today. We look forward to reconnecting with you next time. Have a blessed week.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. Make sure that you are mindful of all of the ministry opportunities and taking heed of those opportunities to be engaged as well as informed in ministry. Amen. Amen. On today, we want to celebrate all of those who are celebrating a birthday in the month of September. If you're celebating the month of September, put it in the comment section. Let us know. Let us know that it's your birthday, because the day that you were born, God gifted into the world a blessing, a gift to all you encounter. And we thank God for each and every one of you. And listen, I know it's a whole lot of September babies at Ellington. And so we want you to put your name in the comment section. And those who are seeing those names, wish them a happy birthday. But we just thank God for each and every one of you. And again, happy birthday and many, many more, because God is blessing you even right now. Amen. Now for our benediction. Now may the grace of God, the love of Jesus, and the sweet blessed communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with you throughout the day. And when you lie down tonight, and when you rise early in the morning, whether it's a day of labor or a day of leisure, whether you feel good or you don't feel so well at all, whether things are going your way or not, may God's grace and mercy undergird you to support you, cover you to protect and shield you, and surround you to bless and keep you. Yes, now, henceforth, and forever. And remember that the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the people of God said together, amen, amen, and amen. God bless you, and God keep you, is our prayer.